You know this because you've been to my shows before. So I've already told you this. One time Bertrand Russell said, there's no way to prove that the entire universe wasn't created 5 minutes ago, complete with memories. So, I started telling people at my shows, I would always come to a certain point while I talk about that, and I discovered that there are some people that are very disturbed by that idea. And there are some people that are very encouraged by it. And then that's me. But Bertrand Russell didn't think of this. I thought of this fact. This is a fact. And you don't know it for yourself, this is a fact. This exact moment, right now, is the beginning of the entire rest of eternity. Isn't that weird? It's true. It's weird. Really true. And it's just as weird as can be.
I got to thinking that I think we're right in the exact middle of eternity.
We are. It's infinitely backwards and infinitely forwards. So we're right in the exact.
The way, I got to tell you how I figured this out. I was sitting there on a tractor one day, driving for my dad, you know, and I got to thinking, well, if you had an infinitely long rope and you grabbed it in the middle, how would you know it was the middle? It would take way too long to go to one end and you'd never get to the end. So you can't measure it. So, you have to always be right in the middle of it. This is it. Wake up to that. It's so wonderful. It is also complete and total.
This is kind of like it, Butch, but a couple of years ago,
five minutes ago,
this memory occurred. This was brought about that I was at the Tassajara Zen Center in California and teaching a songwriting class. And then they had a little a room where they sold the little amulets and stuff and t-shirts. And it occurred to me that I could find extra large t-shirts and extra small, but I couldn't find any extra medium.
It's true. It's like, how medium can you get? It makes perfect sense to me.
Now listen, Dallas isn't that far from Lubbock. You know.
Depends on which way you go.
It's Lubbock's halfway there.
He's right.
If you would go the other way, it'd take a long time. It's the same there. I finally figured out why I think it was Katie that asked, why did the chicken not cross the road? And I figured out it was because he realized that he was already on the other side. Because if he went the other direction, he'd wind up he'd already be there.
And that's what Roxy wrote about being on the other side.
So remember, a mind is a terrible thing to waste.
Butch used to always mention to people that when we got into things like this, it's like, you know what? If you were ever on a ride with the two of us across Texas
at night, Boy, yeah.
It takes a long time. We have some very weird conversations.
Make sure your son's driving.
Yeah.
Recently, that's the way we do it.
Yeah.
Yeah.